All good, all good in the hood. All good, all good in the hood. All good, all good in the hood. All good in the hood.
It's all good.
It's all good.
It's all good in the hood.
All good in the hood.
Welcome back. How are you?
Thank you for watching.
You doing good? Are you doing good? Having a good day?
Cooper's having a weird day now. I don't know why he doesn't like when we do this.
So we're talking about motorcycles. Do you ride a motorcycle? Do you want to ride a motorcycle? Why is riding motorcycles a thing?
It's just so fun. I think it's like the best way to get from here to there.
It seems really dangerous.
Yeah.
It seems like it's very economical. Like you don't need a lot of money once you have a motorcycle. You can't take a lot of stuff.
You could take a backpack with stuff, but like you don't have a place to just stick a cake.
So I guess the question is, do people ride motorcycles because it looks cool?
I mean, I think it's just because it's really awesome.
Or they're the type of person that's into pushing the limits.
Yeah.
Does it seem like normal people, like, that are worried about things don't ride motorcycles? So
you think normal people worry about things?
It's normal. I think normal people worry about things. That's why we have things like seatbelts and helmets, and because there is people in the industry that are like, we need to like protect ourselves. Every time we go outside, we need to protect ourselves. People walking around wearing surgical masks because they don't want to breathe the air. Filtered water.
But how about like...
I think if anything, the society we live in now is safer than it's ever been. Like, you go back to the old Wild West or something, people are getting shot out in the streets.
And they were riding on horses. They didn't wear helmets. They went around on horses. And there wasn't... I mean, the motorcycle is like the mechanical horse. Like, yeah, you have the horsepower.
People were riding horses because there weren't cars.
Right, okay.
Now there are cars.
Okay, but so it's the same thing as riding a horse around. Mm-hmm. I mean, you're just small. Mm-hmm. You're compact.
Yeah. But unless you live way out in the country, you don't see people riding horses.
And
like
I don't
for
want,
like and actual to get somewhere.
Right.
Nobody's doing
it's
that.
It's like for fun now more.
It's for equestrian. It's kind of an elitist thing. Or you're like a hillbilly riding a horse.
I'm going to ride my horse.
Yeah. Like what's that old town road? You know, the country trap.
Oh.
Song that became a huge thing. And he's all talking about all these Western concepts, but it's a hip hop song. But I mean, a lot of people, yeah. Seahorses, but not many people ride horses. Have you been on a horse?
I've ridden a horse a couple times, like in Bryce Canyon, and when I was in Mexico, it was like mm-hmm. a thing to do. But then I'm like, I don't want to be on a horse because I think it's bullshit that I'm like some white lady riding on a horse.
A horse is an animal that has instincts and it's trying not to die. A motorcycle has no instincts. The only instincts it has is the person, the brain that's operating it, and it's like high powered, can go very fast, can do a lot of things.
And then like, I mean, just circumstantial, like like an accident isn't because you.
Yeah, it's not operator error. I think most accidents on motorcycles are caused by somebody that's not
so
involved.
Most
but that's
accidents
what I mean.
Are caused by failure to negotiate a turn. That is what most accidents occur.
Yeah, but then you have to worry about external conditions like gravel or rain or ice.
Like there's oil on the road.
Or oil. Mm-hmm. Or if it's hot. There's so many external conditions. So that's what I'm saying. Is it just the risk factor that you're like, I'm going to ride a motorcycle because that looks badass?
So, but when I learned how to ride a motorcycle, I moved to Oregon and I learned how to ski. And I learned how to ride a mountain bike and I got a dual sport motorcycle. And so it wasn't like this big scary thing to me. Mm-hmm. I mean, sure, people busting down the highway at 90 miles an hour and, you know, you're not in a box. There's no box protecting you. It's dangerous, but it's inherently dangerous to be without a box around you and like flying down the highway. But I didn't really think about it like that because I really just want to ride on the trail. I want to ride off-road and be in the woods. Mm-hmm. That was why I learned how to ride a motorcycle, because I wanted to be in the woods. It's another way to go in the woods.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but you can walk or hike in the woods.
I mean, it's so much more fun, though, on two wheels. Like, everything is more fun on two wheels. I mean, I really like bicycles for that reason. Like, it's just fun to be, like, you know, you get, like, a little speed going and you, like.
Mm-hmm. It just seems like you are, like, can't relax. If you're on a motorcycle, you got to be hyper aware of everything going on around you all the time. And that can get a little, like, we're driving in cars. You got your coffee between your legs. You're rolling a doobie over here. Who knows what? You could be doing all kinds of things. Mm-hmm. Like, so you're not even driving. Driving's the least thing you're doing. Mm-hmm. You're thinking about everything. People are doing their makeup, like, on their way to work.
That's not safe, though, distracted driving.
I know, but it's like you get bailed out because you're in a box.
Mm. And the other thing about motorcycles is you have to be, the elements have a big effect on you. Like if it's windy, when you're coming in and out of a tunnel and you're next to a tractor trailer and then the tractor trailer falls behind and now there's a big wind and like rain and like you have to worry about what your clothing is to make sure you don't have hypothermia.
And I mean, I don't ride a motorcycle. But it seems like if I did, I would be riding like on the back roads, like on the highways, and not on the freeway.
Well,
like with tractor trailers passing you and like you passing them. And
that's just a way to get from here to there. I mean, that's how you get to the dirt roads, is you ride on the highway for between here and there, and then you're in the woods.
Hmm. Well, I just wonder, like, I know the insurance is more expensive to have a motorcycle?
I mean, they don't want to give you, like, life insurance. They want to know if you ride a motorcycle.
Yeah.
Because you have a high-risk behavior. That's a check.
Yeah, you have a high-risk behavior, so.
So isn't skiing a high-risk behavior, though?
But I'm saying, what is the allure of riding a motorcycle? Is it an image thing? Or is it just adrenaline?
I guess it's adrenaline. I mean, I think it just feels really good. Like, it's super fun, and I think because you have so much control, and because there are such high risk in it, you have to be on your game and you have to pay attention. You have to know, you have to be watching everything around you. And it isn't just about you. It's about everybody around you and what they're doing.
Mm-hmm.
And
that sounds like paranoia.
I mean, but I guess my risk tolerance is high and I don't feel like afraid to do that. I feel like I'm in control of my own destiny, and if I'm going to have an accident, then it's not going to be on purpose.
Yeah, and you have some housewife in an SUV drinking her Starbucks and spilling it and swerving into you. You're not in control of that.
No.
Shoot. Sounds like you're trusting the world around you to be like to be aware. And as far as I know, that's not the case. People are pretty dense. So, yeah, I don't know. I like the image of it. I've wanted to ride a motorcycle just so I wear a leather jacket and not be like called a poser. Because if you wear a leather biker jacket, people automatically think you ride a motorcycle. When they find out you don't, they're like, oh, you're a poser. I'm like, no, I just like leather jackets. Like if I were to wear glasses that didn't have a prescription in them, or don't even have glass in them, I get made fun of. Do you wear glasses?
Didn't you get called out for wearing a yellow sweater because people were like, whoa, what's this yellow sweater?
And well, that's just in this town that we live in. Because
you can't have style or like do anything. Yeah, if I lived in a
city, that wouldn't be anything, because there's so many different things in a city that you just like process that you're not going to like be able to call one thing out that's weird, because there's probably somebody who has like horns implanted in their head.
Have you heard them before?
I've heard about them. They're good things. They're really good things. Maybe. And I've never done sound for hip hop. I've listened to a lot of it, so
What are you kind of anticipating from Vitamin D? What are you?
Lots of energy. Yeah.
I would say that. Because if we don't have the energy, then it doesn't like spill out into the crowd. So we definitely get really into it.
And you guys are going to That's a maiden voyage for my new green speakers.
Sweet. Blast it out.
Yeah, it'll be fun.
Let's see if we can get Washougal waked up.
Yeah.
They're like,
right.
Please stop it.
There's some pretty big deals up here. The Recluse Clutch.
Who designed it?
Jeremy Deming with Jeremy Design.
So come take a look if you haven't bought your raffle ticket. Yeah. Go get one. Put it in the boxes. We are going to draw them. We're not going to announce them, but we're going to draw them.
There.
And put them on the
hold it.
And you need to come up and check your raffle ticket.
It's our wrap girl.
And that's going to happen at 8:30.
Yeah. Dope.
Yeah, it is badass. Let's get Dirtastic.
Yeah.
Yeah. What do I think about vitamin D? Vitamin D is my favorite. Lady rapper. April Donovan, AP Real.
Yay.
I wouldn't want anyone else here other than you. Yeah.
Oh, yay.
Yeah.
Well, I'm hyped to be here.
Good.
And we were driving in and I could see all the ladies
wrapping
around. And I was like, oh my God, this is amazing. It's so awesome.
We have like 150 women here.
Yeah.
Just ourselves at Washougal.
It's awesome.
And then they're here for you guys.
Yeah. All the tents, all the cars, all the bikes,
the vibe.
All the ladies.
And all the ladies.
Yeah. And so
what are you wearing?
I'm wearing a spray painted t-shirt that T2 made.
I like it.
So I might be getting kind of high from the paint fumes. I'm not sure.
That's good.
I'm not sure how that will affect my performance.
Because
they have helmets. And this is a public service announcement to wear your helmet. Especially a cool one like this. But
you can get one of these through Dirtastic.
Well, you can get one of these helmets through Dirtastic.
I have three more.
Nice. Sweet. Yes.
Bell is the helmet. Bell Moto Flex 9. The best, absolutely.
Yeah. I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for a helmet, a motorcycle helmet. So I encourage everybody to be wearing their helmet.
Please wear your helmet.
Yeah.
All the time. That's my number one safety rule at Dirtastic. Always wear your helmet, no matter what. I mean, obviously not when you're walking around, but like when you're on your dirt bike. If you're starting it, if you're riding it, always have it on.
Yeah.
It's always like the silly stuff when you think you're like, oh, I got this, whatever, and then you just like fall on the ground and night.
Yeah. Let's keep those heads nice. Keep it pretty. Now I'm shaking, drinking all this coffee. Check that.
Just warming up. Oh, I didn't see you there. We're Vitamin D.
Thank you for having us.
We're very happy to be here. Dirtastic. Kind of want some brap, though. Can you do that after 5? No. We'll be right back.
Can I kick it?
Yes, you can.
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 Well, I'm gone.
Go on then.
Can I kick it to all my people who could quest like a tribe does? That's why I never ask for help. I do this for my homies and I do it for myself. I go 0 to 100, homie, real quick. Real quick, whole crew on that real shit. 0 to 100, homie, real quick. Real quick, real fucking quick, homie. 0 to 100, homie, real quick.